Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about what is process and what are the types based on the process. So let us talk about it. So process is nothing but any transition from one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state is known as process. So it is basically the change of from one form to another form, just like energy. But in this case, there are also many factors that would depend in the process, that is to convert from one form to another form, that is pressure, volume and temperature. And in this case, we can also make a particular state function to be constant while transforming that is one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state. So let us talk about it. This would be the types of the process that I'm going to talk about. So talking about the first one, that is isothermal process. So what is this actually? A process in which the temperature of the system remains constant throughout the transformation is called as isothermal process. Again, let me give you a short example so that it would be very much good for you to understand that what is actually isothermal process. Again, I will consider the same, that is the piston mode. So suppose if I have considered a gas which has been enclosed in a piston, which has been enclosed in a cylinder with a piston on it, and if the gas has been expanding, or if the gas has been now compressing, so what happens is there is the possibility that in that case the temperature of the gas would change, because as we know, suppose if the volume of the gas, of suppose if it increases, then the temperature will decrease, or it depends on what I am talking about, a particular gas. And pressure is but obvious that it would change, as well as the volume is also something which would change. But if I maintain the temperature of that process, that if I maintain the temperature in that process, then what will happen is that kind of process in which the volume, in which the pressure or the volume or any parameter or state function will change, but not the temperature, that kind of process is known as isothermal process. So in this case, the system's temperature or the temperature of the system will remain constant throughout these changes that we observe, that throughout the changes of the pressure or the, throughout the changes of the volume also, but the temperature won't be changed. So this was the first one. And in this case, in isothermal process, basically delta U, that is the internal energy, is remaining constant, that is delta U is equals to zero. So this is the condition that we should know, and but obvious, that is there is no change in temperature, so therefore delta T will also be zero. So initial stage of the system will have a temperature T1, and final stage will also will have the temperature as T1 itself. So there is no change in the temperature, and hence it is said to be isothermal process. So now talking about the next one, that is isobaric process. So what is isobaric process actually? Any process conducted in such a manner that the pressure of the system remains constant throughout the change, that kind of system, or that kind of process that we maintain for a particular system is said to be isobaric process. So let me give you another example. So this example would be very much easy for you to understand. Suppose if a gas has been enclosed in a particular room, and that has a particular pressure in that case. So the initial pressure, suppose let me make the value of the pressure as P1. So suppose in that case the pressure has been maintained as P1, and suppose if I have introduced more gas in a particular constant volume of the container, and if I introduce more number of gases, so what will happen is the pressure will increase. So in this case, suppose if I have to reduce the pressure, or if I have to maintain the pressure as the P1 itself, because now if the gas has been entered in that particular container, so the pressure will be more, and in this case that pressure, which is more than the previous one, let me name it as P2. So the P1 and P2, the both are of different values, they will have different value. So for in that case, so what I am going to do is, if I increase the volume of the container, so not to increase so much that the pressure will be very much low compared to that of P1, but it should be equal to the P1 itself. So in this case, what I'm doing is, even though if I'm changing the parameters, or if even though if I'm changing the state function, like the volume, but I'm maintaining the pressure to be constant. So if I've increased the volume and I've let the pressure P1 to reduce to the pressure, let the pressure P2 to reduce the pressure like P1. So in this case, the initial stage of the gas which was having a pressure, it was P1, and it have went to P2, but again it have came to P1. So in this case, the pressure is being maintained constant. And in this case, when we are talking about isobaric process, the pressure should be actually maintained constant throughout the whole transformation, and that is nothing but isobaric process. So in this case, there will be no change in pressure, therefore delta P is considered to be zero. And this kind of process where delta P has which is zero, that kind of process is known as isobaric process. Talking about the next one, that is isochoric process. It is basically any process during which volume of the system remains constant is known as isochoric process. So this kind of, in this process, what happens is we could change any of the state function like pressure or temperature, but there should be no change in volume. For example, if I would say, suppose we know pressure cooker, suppose if I have or anyone makes food in that, so the pressure will increase, because what we are doing is we are maintaining the volume as it is, as well as the volume has been fixed in that case, even though we are not letting the part or not letting the matter to be escaped from the pressure cooker. So that means more the pressure that we are maintaining by maintaining the volume, and we are not changing the volume actually. So any kind of process in which the volume is not being changed or volume doesn't change, that kind of process is known as isochoric process. A very simple thing that we have got to know now. So I could write it as, where the change in volume, that is delta V, is nothing but V2 minus V1, or V1 minus V2, we could consider anyway. So it should be basically zero. So any process where there is no change in volume is said to be isochoric process. So now let us talk about the another one, that is adiabatic process. So a process in which there is no exchange of heat between the system and the surrounding is known as adiabatic process. We know, suppose if we consider, if we have maintained a particular glass which is filled with cold water, and if I have kept it near to a glass of hot water, so what will happen is the heat will transfer. So in this case, the heat can be transferred, and this kind of process won't be said to be adiabatic process. So adiabatic process are basically those kind of process in which the system doesn't exchange the heat with the surrounding, or there is no change of the heat which is present in the system. For example, if I would I would say an example like a hot cup of tea. Suppose if that has been kept in a container which has been isolated with the surrounding. So what will happen is the heat won't get to the surrounding. So there will be no exchange of heat. So similarly, even the tea which is kept in thermos, so the heat is not being exchanged with the surrounding. So that kind of system that we, or that kind of process that we maintain throughout is known as adiabatic process. So in this case, since there is no exchange of heat, so I could write it as, because there should be no change in heat, so I would write it as Q is equals to zero. This Q is, there is no transfer of heat. So talking about the next process, that is the cyclic process. So what is cyclic process actually? A process in which state of a system undergoes a series of changes and returns back to its initial state is known as cyclic process. It is very simple to just like the displacement, as we know that suppose if any particles origins from a particular point and come back to the same point, that in that case the displacement would be said to be zero. So similarly here also, in cyclic process, a kind of process in which the initial stage will turn into some kind of different changes, and suppose that changes will lead back again to the initial stage, that kind of process is said to be a cyclic process. So for example, I will give you, suppose again in this case, I've maintained pressure volume in this case, and I know that suppose if a pressure changes from P1 V1 to suppose P2 V2, and again this P2 V2 this pressure will again, if it come back to P1 V1 or if we maintain to come back to again P1 V1, so in that process basically this would said to be a cyclic process, because as we could see that in this process it goes from initial state to final state, as well as from final state to initial state. So in this case there is no change in the initial parameters, so this kind of process will be said to be a cyclic process. And moreover, suppose if I have considered the same that is the example of the gas which is enclosed in a cylinder and with a frictionless piston, so suppose if the gas expands, so the piston will rise and there will be increase in volume. And again, suppose at anyhow, suppose if the volume reduces to the initial stage only, so in this case the process, what there was different changes, that is from the volume of V1 to a volume of V2 and again back to V1, so in this process this have maintained the volume as V1, so therefore that kind of process will be said to be a cyclic process, or any process where it changes and come back again to the initial stage it is said to be a cyclic process. So for cyclic process there are few conditions that we know, that we should know, that is in that case delta U will be is equals to zero, means the change in internal energy will be zero along with the change in enthalpy. So this is basically cyclic process. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know that is what is process and what are the types of process, and you will share this video with your friends too. And yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.